Video, we're going to talk about how to make scatter plots with and without the line of best fit and scatter matrices or a matrix scatter plot so that you can look at a bunch of scatter plots at once. Now, to do scatter plots, you need two continuous variables. And so, one thing you can check in variable view is that you have at least two things listed as scale. If they aren't listed at, excuse me, they aren't listed as scale out here, it's not gonna let you do the line of best fit. And so sometimes chart builder can be a little confusing because you're not totally sure why it won't let you do something. And it's often because of this measure column out here. If it's not the right measure, it won't let you run it. Okay. So I'm gonna go into chart builder. So go graphs and then chart builder. It may ask you something about your variables the first time you do it. You can say okay, or if you don't have any of the variables typed out here, it will make you do that part first. So for scatter plots, it's here under scatter dot in the gallery options. And you have several different options. So I'm going to talk about three of them: a regular scatter plot, a grouped scatter plot, or clustered scatter plot, and the scatter matrix. You're really only going to use one of these, but I'm going to show you how to do all three. So anytime you have a type of design you want to do down here, you can either double click or drag and drop to get this preview. Okay. And it clearly says right here, chart preview uses example data, but just a reminder that the chart that you're creating is not what the dots appear to be here. So they don't really match. And it sort of looks like it's going to match, but it's not an accurate depiction of what's going on. So let's pick two fun variables here. So positive and negative emotion. And so I have to have two scale variables indicated by the little ruler. And you can right click on these variables and change them. So if you have the wrong one just because you imported it from Excel, and Excel, anytime there's no decimals, it automatically assumes it's nominal, you can change it right here to make your life a little better. So I'm gonna drag this one into X and this one into Y. If you're just doing correlations, X and Y don't matter. If you're doing simple regression, be sure you put the IV in X and the DV in Y. I could go through under X-axis here and go ahead and change the labels if I wanted to make them more appropriate. So positive emotion words. And then always hit apply. I always forget, but be sure you hit apply. If I knew the min and max, I could force it to have a specific min and max. So if you have a 1-to-7 scale, your chart should go 1-to-7. I know the minimum is 0, so I'm going to force it to have a 0 on the x-axis point here. But I don't remember the highest point, so I'm going to leave it alone. Again, be sure you hit apply. Under y-axis, I'm going to do the same thing. So oops, negative emotion words. I know the minimum zero, and I don't remember the maximum, so hit apply. That's all I'm going to do for a simple scatter plot, so hit OK. So here we have the relationship between the number of positive emotion words that someone would say on the House or Senate floor and the number of negative emotion words that they would say. So it looks like there's kind of this negative relationship between the two. As I get more positive, I get less negative. But if you weren't sure, you could double click on the graph. And there are a lot of properties and options you can change in this particular window. One of my favorite ones to change is the background color. And so I think you double click on it again. And I always change it to, so I just double clicked on the graph. Fill and border, I make it transparent. Okay. And so that makes the background white instead of gray, which is the automatic option in SPSS. All right, now if I wanted to actually know is this negative or positive, and I wasn't sure, because both variables are listed as scale, I can click on this little line here. So it's add fit line at total. And that will let me add the line of best fit in a linear fashion. If you wanted to do something else, you get this little properties window. You could do the mean of y, apply that one, or linear. It auto does linear for you. Lowest curves, which are not straight. You'll see it's a little bit of a wacky curve. It's a roving average. Quadratic curves are squared functions. And then cubic curves are x to the third functions. Okay. So I'm going to leave this as linear. Okay. And I find this little line here, the little box kind of annoying sometimes because it's in the way. So I'm going to turn that bad boy off. And that'll just keep me from having the equation on there because it's kind of difficult to move sometimes. All right, be sure you're hitting apply when you're changing these things. Otherwise, it will not let you, it will just ignore what you're doing. And then I'm going to close this window and then it will auto re-add the line here. So it's a slight negative relationship. It's not as strong as you would think, but there is a slightly negative correlation between positive words and negative words. So that's a simple scatter plot. One other thing to add is if I wanted to, so I double clicked on that graph, if I wanted to figure out who these little points are out here, like there's this one dude way out here, different from everyone else, I could take this bullseye icon, it's data label mode, and click on the dot I'm interested in, and that will tell me the line number in SPSS. So let me close that. I'm going to go back to the data itself. And what that does is it tells me it's line 13. So it matches this number thing out here. So it's not any specific participant number you have. It's this line number. So those are simple scatter plots. Let's try a clustered scatter plot. So let's say you have a more complex design where you have some sort of categorical variable, like I have party affiliation here, and two continuous variables. So I'm going to go graphs, then chart builder. It stays all set up because I haven't closed SPSS, but now I want to switch to a grouped scatter plot. So I'm going to double click on it, and you'll see that my two continuous variables stay where they were at, and so I still need two continuous variables, one on X, one on Y. It'll let you use categorical variables, but it's not quite appropriate. You should be doing more of a bar chart. I'm going to take party affiliation and put it into set color. Now, anytime it has set color up here for your cluster graphs, you have to have a categorical or a nominal variable. So you make sure it has to say nominal out here. When I did that, I got an extra point. It did auto-change all of my nice and pretty labels to the boring ones, so I would have to fix those. But under group color point, it'll let me change the legend label, and I can actually reorder. So let's say I wanted to put Republican second, I could reorder them. so I can do it by label or by value. And remember, value is the number that's underneath there. So when I added these value labels, I made them 0 and 1. Okay. Apply. All right, I'm going to hit OK. Now remember, when you're doing charts, all of these labels should look pretty. Right? So I shouldn't have this POSMO or POSEMO down here. It should look more like I have my party affiliation up here. So let's say I wanted to change that, so I double click on the graph to get the properties window. And this is a little annoying sometimes, but what you do is you click once on the thing you want to change, so it gets highlighted, click one more time, and then it'll let you type. So I could change that here. And I would do the same thing for this one. So click once to get it, second time to get it to where I can type in it. Get off. Now, if I wanted to change the length of the X and Y axis, I could click on the Y axis to get it here, and it's under scale, and I could force this to be a specific range. Now, it's done this 0 to 8 because the data is 0 to 7, but if I, let's say, I wanted to instead do the increment in one unit at a time, I could force it to have 1 through 7 on there. I'm going to let it do its automatic thing because it's a little easier to read. There we go. and then I could change the font of the size. Labels and ticks is where I can turn on and off the axis label. So if you forget to turn on the axis label, this is a good place to turn it to get the axis label. I don't really want to do any of that stuff, so I'm going to leave it alone. Now, I have two groups. I have Republicans and Democrats, and I have two sets of dots. So there are blue and green for my different groups. And I could add a fit line at total, or even more interestingly, I can add a fit line at subgroups. So you notice this little icon is now available because I have the right type of graph for it. And so I'm going to add fit line at subgroups and turn off that stinking label. And so what that's doing for me is it's adding a different regression line for each group. And so this is a good way to tell, close both of these, if my two groups have different correlations. And I would say they do. Republican line looks small and negative, and the Democrat line is totally flat. And so they have a different correlation. But the cool thing about this graph is it lets me see the overall correlation. If I look at just ignoring the color, and then this correlation separated by group. Okay, so that is a grouped scatter plot. Last but not least is a scatter matrix. So let's go graphs and then chart builder. And in SPSS, it used to be called a scatter matrix. It's now called a scatter plot matrix. Same idea. I'm going to hit reset so we don't have the same variables. And then double click on scatter plot matrix. And so you'll see that it has just one box. So you're kind of wanting there to be an X and a Y because that's every other option possible, but it only has one. So what you'll do here is highlight several variables you're interested in. So let's do positive and negative because we've been doing that one. So I'm going to hold down the control key to get multiple variables. And then I also have this fun death variable out here. Okay, so I've got all three of those highlighted. I'm going to drag and drop them into where it says scatter matrix until I get this red cross plus. And that lets me put in all three variables at once. This chart version is a little cranky sometimes. And sometimes it'll let you run more than three or four. Sometimes it won't. And I haven't found a good reason why. So if it gives you an error, just run less variables. So do three of them instead of five. So hit OK. Now these are not something that you would normally present in a research paper. Or you might. You just might clean it up a little bit because it's a big waste of space. But the blank ones are because that is the correlation with itself. So positive emotion and positive emotion, so it just left it blank for you. And they're the same on the bottom and the top. So these three charts are the exact same thing as these three charts, just rotated. But it's a kind of a quick way to look at several correlations at once, or if you're doing data screening, linearity rules at all at once. It's got the same basic functions that the other ones do, so I could add a whole bunch of fit lines. To the graph, I could point out specific little outliers out here. So if I add all those fit lines, I can see if there are any correlations. Okay. Not really. And so this graph really is mainly for you to look kind of quickly at a bunch of different variables at once. Now, I've been told by several students, if you go to graphs and then legacy dialogues, and then scatter dot. Okay, so legacy dialogues are all the options that this is how chart builder used to be for SPSS. And then matrix scatter, that it will let you do more variables at once. So let's pick a bunch of these pronouns. So I'm going to pick five variables up here, I, we, you, he, they, and I pronouns, and put it into matrix variables. Actually, let me do a whole bunch of graphs at once, whereas chart builder version, so analyze, I'm sorry, graphs and then chart builder, sometimes will limit you in the number of charts. Okay. So there are kind of two ways to get this type of graph. So this video covered regular scatterplots, group scatterplots, and scatter matrices.